I've been in additive manufacturing for 15 years. I understand the impact it can have on innovation, but also ultimately on the release date of a product. I lead the polymer additive manufacturing facility at the Advanced Manufacturing Research Centre in Sheffield. We'll have a research partner come to us with a specific requirement. With hundreds of engineers, and we have hundreds of projects live. We had individual systems, but the software and the process was so involved that only one or two people were trained to use.
We've been having trouble with getting the fibre to process.
We only had a small amount of time in which to deliver the solution.
There is a big push for high accuracy parts.
We needed 3D prints that could withstand the high temperatures that's involved in welding.
I decided that what I could do is implement the Form 2 printers in a suite that would serve all of the requirements of site. It would be highly beneficial to have additive manufacturing units. The software is very intuitive. Engineers here can pick it up very quickly. So it breaks down barriers, and that really helps speed up research projects.
In the automotive and aerospace industries, it means that I have the freedom to design pretty much anything that I want.
We were able to include geometry in the part, which allowed them to be installed really quickly.
We can be a lot more innovative and test things much more quickly without having to go through a really rigorous design process.
We need something quickly. 3D printing equipment is the best way to produce it. It's so simple to use.
Now we have just over 100 engineers trained. So what we plan to do is use the setup as a model and replicate that into some of our partners' facilities. They want something that's easy to use, something that they can scale. And the Form 2 suite is an obvious answer to that. It was far better for our site to open that knowledge up, to train many users and allow them to use the system and then increase their knowledge